5 things you should know about at-home COVID tests. Many at-home COVID-19 tests are now available in the US. This makes COVID testing more convenient. Yet there are things to consider if you're planning to use them frequently. With cheaper COVID testing, the US government now wants insurance companies to pay for them. On January 10, the Biden administration required insurance companies and group health plans to cover the costs of at-home COVID-19 tests. This should level up access of many Americans to free tests. That order took effect 5 days later and covered any over-the-counter COVID diagnostics authorized, approved, or cleared by the US FDA. A family of 4 on the same plan could get up to 32 tests covered by their health plan per month, according to the Department of Health and Human Services. So what are things you should know about free over-the-counter COVID test kits? 1. The tests are not completely free. Someone needs to carry the cost, though Americans will benefit at the start. KFF VP Cynthia Cox explained that the total bill could be billions of dollars, and the exact value would depend on factors. 2. Speaking of costs, if insurers use the time-tested playbook, the cost would fall into the customer's laps. That would totally defeat the free access to many cheap at-home test kits. If that happens, not many would be willing to test themselves more often. This would contradict the approach of testing to fight outbreaks. 3. Why your premiums aren't going up again. Kaiser Family Foundation said that last year, insurers had the chance but mostly didn't do it. One possible reason was most of them earned more than enough. If you're thinking that's impossible, think again. When COVID exploded in the US, major lockdowns were enforced to contain the situation. These lockdowns effectively limit everyone's movement unless there's an emergency. Most people stayed at home and that prevented insurers from paying out. Fewer accidents, delayed surgeries, and fewer hospital visits contributed to the diminished payout. If you get some money back as rebate, that's good. However, your insurer might have collected more. 4. Let's say the covering for over-the-counter COVID test kits persists for months. Will it impact you directly? It's possible based on factors. If your insurer only commits $12 per test and you paid for $30, you'll shoulder the remaining $18. If you paid for tests from retailers not covered by your insurer, that's also on you. 5. While the plan won't really result in totally free tests, it might greatly stimulate competition. Competition between manufacturers is a good indicator of pricing going down. As long as the demand doesn't devour the supply, the competition might drag prices further down. Share thoughts in the comment section. Till our next video, thanks for watching.